So I got this pulley puller kit. I rented it, and it's got all kinds of nifty little attachments and stuff, you know. So what I'm gonna do is use that to get this off. Let me see if I can get this thing lined up. What I'm going to do is, I had to buy these bolts. These are special. These bolts fit the thread. None of the bolts inside the kit fit that thread. Basically, what you do is you have this part here that pivots, and then this part. I think I want to have this in here with this on it. And then bolt this to the car. So that's the challenge, is to do this. Everybody had to pay and pay. A hustle here and a hustle there. New York City is the place where they said, hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side. I said, hey, Joel, take a walk on the wild side. In a better position, so I'm gonna shut the camera off, go ahead and do this, and then start it up again. The dry belt tensioner is gonna be this guy right here. To be honest with you, I have no idea how that's on. Well, maybe this must be that bolt right in the center. I'm gonna give it a shot and see what happens. Turns out that I was right. This bolt here is the one that takes it off. Now with that out, it looks like that. So I'm going to set this over here. Oh, miscellaneous pile. And then come back over here. This is what I want to remove. And you can see there's a bunch of bolts holding it on. They're all different sizes, so that's bizarre. But actually, let's follow the instructions. Remove the power steering pump with lines. Move the power steering pump aside. Ooh, that's gonna be this guy here. I gotta get this out of the way, because this part also is coming out as part of this whole big thing. So I gotta move this, get this out of the way, and I have no idea how to do that, but I will figure it out and let you know. So it looks to me like, if you look at this pulley, you see that there's a bolt right there. Rotate around, there's a bolt there, and another bolt right there. So using these holes in the pulley, I will get to those and take them out. And then I think this thing's going to slide up this way, because it's down in between here and here. So we'll see what happens. Okay, so I got the power steering pump out of the way. Kind of messed up the pulley a little bit right here. I had to pry it out. It was really in there. If I did it again, I'd probably be more careful and not break it, but I don't think that's going to affect much. The next step is I have to disconnect this thermostat bypass pipe from, it's this little bolt here, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Okay, so I got this loose from the engine. Right here. And I had to remove this nut here, which helps to hold that pipe down. And then I pried off of here underneath this pipe here and wiggled it back and forth, pried gently until it popped up. You can see that it goes down into it pretty far, and there's an O-ring there, which is going to have to be replaced. I believe it comes with the kit I bought. So that's off. Okay, so next step. Disconnect the radiator outlet hose from the coolant pump. That's going to be this right here. So I'll do that. Okay, I got the pulley off. And the next step, according to the instructions, is remove the lower crankcase position sensor wiring harness bracket from the engine front cover. Disconnect the crankshaft position sensor wiring harness. That's that down there. This is the crank position sensor. Can you see it? This thing down here. And I'm supposed to remove the sensor wiring harness bracket from the engine, which is probably that bolt, but I'll get underneath and take a look. That's what it looks like. As you can see, if I could just get this light to be where I want it to be. Okay. This is the wire coming out. This little red thing here. And that's the bracket. So take that out. Okay, well, I could not get the electrical connector disconnected. So, I mean, if I worked at it some more, I might be able to do it, but I figured it would be easier to just take off the whole crankshaft position sensor, which I did. It's this thing here, this blue thing. And I let it swing aside, and then I put the bolts for it back in so I don't lose track of which bolt goes where. This bolt's for the bracket. I put it back in also. So, you can see this antifreeze is dripping right there. Right. See, there's a drip coming down. Coming right from this thing. It's got to be this, I hope. All oily. The next step on the list, I got to turn the page, and it says remove the engine front cover bolts. That's going to be all these bolts here, and there's different sizes, so I have to make sure I keep track of which goes where. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 of them. So I think that's kind of like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where's my finger? 5, 6, 7, 8. There's one here. 9. I don't know, I'll figure out where they are. Talk to you later.